welcome to day three of Stronger by the Day in our eternal homage to the great piano, the grand piano himself, Rich Piana. So today we're going to talk briefly about patience. Patience is incredibly important in strength training. Nothing of worth, nothing of value can be conveyed or can be achieved in a short time frame, especially in strength training. Out of all the physical qualities, strength is the slowest to adapt. Cardiovascular fitness, you will notice a difference in 24 hours to 48 hours. Having done a workout, you will adapt to that stimulus that quickly. That's how quickly the cardiovascular system, respiratory system work. However, for strength, you're talking in terms of adaptation to see an accrued change in the order of weeks to months. So for example, a popular program, squat program, talked about it a lot, Russian squat routine. It was a 6-week program, which if followed correctly, and if you get the results that are ideal, you'll get a 5% increase, or 5 to 10% increase on 1RM max squat. That's in a month and a half for a 5% increase. That on, in terms of cardiovascular fitness, weight loss, you will see a much quicker return on cardiovascular fitness and weight loss in a 6-week period. Heck, you'll see transformation programs for weight loss that are 12 weeks in length. No one, not without the help of steroids, is gonna make a transformation in their strength training in 12 weeks. You're not gonna go from 100 kilo bench to 180 kilo bench in 12 months, maybe in 12 years, maybe in 6 years you might get there, depending on where you're starting from and where your base is. It's difficult when you're working with people on a day in, day out basis. So we're in the gym, we're doing our session, maybe a four or five sessions in a week. See them training, so this guy's benching 100 kilos. I'd want from the bench 140 kilos, but it can be easy to get dragged into thinking of short returns in lifting. I've been lifting since I was 31 now. I've been lifting for 13 years, and I'm still getting stronger. I'm still natural, and I'm still getting stronger. And I am nowhere near my prime. My natural prime is about 37, 38. My enhanced prime is probably in my mid-40s. So I still have another 15 years to go of top level training. And then after which I can still train, I can still compete. My masters are powerlifters who are competing in the 90s, 100-year-old, 90-year-old, 80-year-old. There are categories where people are still competing. Still deadlifting. There are 70-year-old men that are deadlifting 220 kilos. They're out there. So it's a lifelong sport. It's not something like sprinting, where you have a very finite window, or something like gymnastics, where there's a very finite window where all of a sudden we're 22, we're 23, and we're too old to compete at the highest level. In powerlifting and strength training, your peak's not till your late 30s, early 40s. So if you're starting, you're 18, there's no fucking rush to go anywhere. If you're 22, there's no rush. If you're 30, there's no rush. If you're 40, there's no rush. You have decades of this to get it right and get it better. So try to incrementally improve things. Think about, what are the acute things you can do right now? You want to work like fuck in the short term. So in the immediate term, on things that we can affect on the immediate term. How your reps are performed. We can affect that in a rep. We can go from a shit rep to a better rep with a bit of thought, a bit of execution, a bit of diligence. We can make a difference between sets. But we're going to become stronger between sets. In fact, we're going to become weaker, so we're going to become more fatigued as the training session goes on. So work like fuck acutely, work like fuck in the medium term, your recovery, your sleep, your nutrition, pay attention on that, show up to training, do your due diligence, practice, deliberate practice, get out of your comfort zone, look at things objectively, try to become a better lifter acutely, and then have patience for the results. Get into the process, trust the process. Don't think, oh fuck, I need to put a ton of kilos on the bench for the next 10 weeks. Doesn't matter. And if you gain it in 10 weeks, chances are you're going to get injured or you're going to lose it. So don't think about short, sharp returns. Think about the long game. Because strength training is a long game. So be patient for the outcome and hustle and work like fuck in the immediate and moderate term on things that you can make a change on, things that you can see a better benefit on. If you go from sleeping 5 hours a week, sorry, 5 hours a night, to getting 8 hours of quality sleep a night, you will notice a difference the next day. Concentrate on that. If you go from eating two meals a day that are of shit quality, to eating 6 meals a day that are of high nutrition, vegetables, lean meats, blah, 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 the whole nine, you will notice a difference within a week. If you go on slow to try rack your squat up 20 kilos, you'll notice a difference in 12 weeks. That difference might be a knee tendinopathy, it might be a glute knee tendinopathy, it might be an overuse injury of what we don't know. All for a 10 to 15 kilo return in 12 weeks. Take the 2 kilos, take the 5 kilos. With time, it'll compound and it'll turn into a big fucking difference. Do the immediate and the moderate term things and have patience for the big outcomes. You'll be in a much better place. Thank you very much for joining us for your strongest day, or stronger by the day, keep fucking that up. Episode 3, day 3. See you tomorrow. This is my new abode. Just got the keys today. So, got all that fun to look forward to in the next few days, moving in. It's literally fuck all here, no couch, no TV, no desk. So that's all to be bought, so that's a fun time, but you know. It's good. Any questions, comments, please leave them below. If you're on Facebook, give us a like, hit up the Cast Iron Strength Facebook page, give me a like there. If you're on YouTube, hit that subscribe button. Leave a comment below if you want to ask me a question. If you want to say anything specific, I'm going to give you 10 minutes of my time every day. So if there's anything specifically you want me to answer, I'm more than willing to answer it. So leave your comments below. If you don't want to leave it in public, send me an email, speedpowerperformance@gmail.com. Catch you tomorrow. Have a good day. Thank you very much. Goodbye.